Hey guys, FDV here. Welcome to my version of Star Wars Episode 2. No need to stall, let's just get into it. Much like my version of Episode 1, the first thing to change is the title. I know with the title Attack of the Clones, George Lucas was trying to go for an Empire Strikes Back type feel. And although I respect that, something just feels really off about the title. I guess it just feels a little misleading because with a title called Attack of the clones only attack like once. Unlike The Empire Strikes Back, where throughout the whole movie our villains are just screwing with our heroes, hence striking back. My title isn't too far off from the original. My version will be called Star Wars Episode 2, The Clone Wars. It's not a huge change, but it's still significant since you're not going to feel misled. So even if the clones don't attack as much, the title of The Clone Wars serves to show which era of Star Wars we're in. So without any further ado, this is Star Wars Episode 2, The Clone Wars. The opening crawl would tell us that more clone droids have been built out of Geonosis, and now they're planning to attack the Republic to not only cripple its economy, but also plunge them into war. The Republic is unaware of the impending doom as they discuss the creation of an army for if such occasion should occur. We open on Coruscant with Palpatine and Tarkin talking to the Jedi Council. Palpatine suggests the creation of an army of the Republic. The Jedi's vote matters, so he really needs them to approve. Since Jedi are the guardians of peace, they're a little hesitant to approve an army. Tarkin argues that a few special teams have already been trained for the occasion, and if they approved an army, more people can be recruited. Obi-Wan, surprisingly, seems to be on their side. He remembers what Qui-Gon said on Tatooine a few years ago. If a new clone army were to be built, they'd be ready for it. And it's just then that he's noticed that the Jedi haven't been preparing. So he agrees that for safety's sake, they should approve an army. But the rest of the council still feels iffy about the whole thing. They tell Palpatine and Tarkin that they'll think it over. Or meditate over, since they're Jedi. All this changes though when out of nowhere Coruscant is attacked. Ships descend and start opening fire. Buildings get blasted, but they don't collapse. The temple gets blasted and it's as if an earthquake shook the place. Some ships land and drop off something. And we see they're dropping off clone droids. This attack is happening mostly in the vicinity of the temple and Congress buildings. But in wake of all this madness, from out of the blue, a separate ship lands into the hangar bay of the Jedi Temple. And out of the ship walks a pale, bald woman with two lightsabers in her hands. She ignites the lightsabers and goes to town. She's quick and agile, fighting off the Jedi as she makes her way up to the main council room. It's kind of like that scene from X-Men 2 when Nightcrawler breached the White House. Meanwhile, Anakin, Padme, and Owen are trying to make sure everyone gets out okay. They were in another room since they aren't part of the Jedi Council. But Anakin sees this mysterious person speed up towards the Jedi Council room, and he chases after her. When she makes it to the main council room, she kills a couple of Jedi, but mostly incapacitates them. Her target is Palpatine. Palpatine and Tarkin are, of course, defenseless. Tarkin is knocked out. Palpatine is left cowardly crawling on the floor, begging for his life. That is until Anakin steps in. As the mysterious woman grabs Palpatine by the collar with one hand and lifts up her lightsaber with the other about to strike, Anakin ignites his lightsaber. They engage in a quick little scuffle, but the surviving Jedi start to get up and backup arrives. Owen, Padme, and more Jedi. She's pretty much cornered in the back of the room, and she has no room to do anything fancy. The only option she has is to escape, and the only way out is through the window. So she pushes a couple of the Jedi back with the Force, cuts the window with her lightsaber, and jumps out. After this, the Jedi feel as though they have no choice but to approve an army. This act of terrorism was obviously a declaration of war, and they will not let this system that has stood for over 1,000 generations fall to their tyranny. And that's right, I said generations. In George's version, Palpatine says that they've stood for over 1,000 years, but there's a huge gap between years and generations. If you look back at the original Star Wars, Obi-Wan says,
"For over 1,000 generations, the Jedi Knights were the guardians of peace and justice in the Old Republic. Before the Dark Times. Before the Empire."
Why are you short-selling yourself, Palpy?